this video is from interview.com. interview.com is a job portal. If you're looking for a job, you can log on to interview.com and you can post your resume with us. In this video, I'm going to talk about Java references. Important points to remember about Java references. A Java reference variable can be of only one type, and once declared, that type can never be changed, although the object it references can change. So it can be of only one type. So we are talking about the reference variable. It can be of only one type. Once it is assigned, it can never be changed, but you can reassign to a different objects. A reference is a variable so that it can be reassigned to other objects unless the reference is declared as final. So if you declare here it is final, you can't reassign it, reinitialize it. A reference variable's type determines the methods that can be invoked on the object the variable is referencing. For example, here I have circle of type shape and we are accepting new of circle object. So based on the class that you mentioned here, this object can invoke methods. So this object can invoke methods which is inside of this type class. Okay, that's what the third point talks about. A reference variable's type determines the methods that can be invoked on the object the variable is referencing. A reference variable can refer to any object of the same type as the declared reference, or this is the big one. It can refer to any of type, subtype of the declared type. They're talking about the base class. Base class can take the object of the subclass. Last point, a reference variable can be declared as a class type or an interface type. If the variable is declared as interface type, it can reference to any object of any class that implements the interface. So you have an interface. Say there are three classes implementing that interface. So you have an interface. There are three classes. Okay, there are three classes that implements that interface. Okay, so you can do like this. So this is what I'm trying to say. So you have an interface and pre-implementation, three classes are implementing these three interfaces. So you can create an object like this. So this object can invoke a method which is available in the interface. Hope these 5 points are useful for your Java interview preparation. Thank you and all the best.